My Seestar says it's delivered. I'm flipping out.
What? The S30, guys.
What?
Outside shoes. Two wrong shoes. Okay, so here it is, the Seestar S30. Comes in a beautiful box. Let's see what's in here. We've got stickers. Pretty cool. Nice stickers. And a really nice portable carrying case. Look at this. Okay. I can't necessarily hold the S50 with one hand, even though it's 5.5 pounds, the S50, right? But this is 3.5 pounds. So, I mean, the portability, the lightweight of this already, feeling good about this. The case also seems very good quality, premium. Let's see what's in here. So we've got some manuals, right? Quick start guide, the solar filter. Okay. And here it is, here's the S30, looking beautiful. And look at this detachable tripod here, very sturdy. I did not know it was going to be this sturdy. This is really, really pretty premium, I would say. This is nice. We've got the charger, of course, the cord. And here it is. Here's the S30. Wow, I mean, I can look at how lightweight this is. This is carry it with one hand. And I will explain in this video why not only is this good for beginners barely getting into astrophotography, but those that are advanced astrophotographers also love this just because of the quick and easy setup. It's fun to use. This isn't just for people that are experts or people that are new. This is literally for anyone, even for children, to learn how to get into astronomy. It's just also makes a wonderful gift. But this is, look at how nice this is. Let's turn it on. And I want to thank ZWO because they actually sent this to me. They reached out to me.
Power on, ready to connect.
There it is. I'm so excited to have it and to show it to all of you. So before we move forward with testing how amazing this telescope is, its multi-function features, I just want to point out real quick the difference in size, weight, height between the S50 and the S30. So check out the difference. I can easily carry this with one hand. And this one, I wouldn't always dare try to pick it up with one hand. So it's lightweight still, of course, but you know, you just can see the portability. The whole point of this is to grab and go, right? Grab and go travel. So camping, hiking, whatever it is, it's great. And what I want to mention is what we're going to test is what this was built for is, of course, solar photography, right? We've got it's the solar lens here. Never look at the sun without your solar lens. And you've got it for lunar photography. You can also look at planets. Now, we know that because the focal length is so small on the sea stars, it's not built for planetary, but it doesn't mean that you can't see planets with it. So that's actually really fun to do as well. And in particular, this excels at deep sky. Deep sky photography is absolutely phenomenal. To be able to see something that's thousands or millions of light years away is just incredible. It excels at deep sky photography, and it excels at solar and at lunar for sure. A lot of fun, hours and hours and hours of fun. And it also has a really cool feature of scenery photograph, and we're going to be testing that to see how it works.
All right, so it's finally nighttime, and now we're going to try some deep space astrophotography and demonstrate just why this incredible smart telescope is so good, not just for beginners, but why it has completely revolutionized the astrophotography industry as we know it for advanced and professionals. I am imaging something 1,500 light years away, right? The Orion Nebula, and it is coming out absolutely incredible. Don't forget that it doesn't even matter if you live in very light polluted skies, right? I live near a huge city, one of the biggest cities in the US, so the image just comes out crisp and clear because the Orion Nebula is the closest star factory, star forming region to Earth, and it's just coming out absolutely beautiful, as you can see in the images. It can AI, that's right, artificial intelligence built in. It can AI denoise your image with just one tap, and I'll show you. The whole point of it is that it helps deliver noise-free, high-quality image directly from the app, and it basically reduces the need for post-processing. Okay, so now I'm going to capture another object, which is the Horsehead Nebula, and something that I want to try with this one is the mosaic mode, or the mosaic framing mode. And basically with this, I'm able to now capture a wider field of view of the object that I want to end up getting. You can choose your angle, you can choose how much of the image you want to be able to capture. So with just one simple tap, as you can see here, the mosaic mode or the framing mode is basically automating the whole entire process of capturing the image, stitching it, and doing the angle adjustments all on its own. And it lets you enjoy this seamless imaging experience while you let the telescope handle all these complexities, and it will deliver this perfectly aligned image and stunning result. All right, let's get the moon now. On the left, we've got the crescent moon, and then on the right, you're gonna see the half moon. Just a few days later, I got that, but I have to admit that secondary camera that you're seeing on the top corner is absolutely everything. You can get the moon in no time. It just took a few seconds. And now during the daytime, check out the snow-covered mountain. And then I actually got a jet, which was really cool. There's a lot of jets here that fly almost every day. And as soon as I got it, I was able to use the tracking mode, and it was very easy to use. And at this point, this was pretty much hands-free. Once you've got the tracking on there, it'll just follow it as long as it needs to. And then I also saw a plane, so might as well get that. Tracking on its own, hands-free, like I mentioned. And then as a little bonus, I got the daytime moon. So yeah, the Seestar S30, absolutely, can't go wrong.